things to be said about the Brahms Trio for violin, horn, and piano. This is, of course, the 150th anniversary of its creation. What makes it unique, one of the many things that makes it unique, is similar to the Kegelstadt Trio written by Mozart for clarinet and piano and... right. And my talented partners. This was the creation of a new ensemble. Very rare that a composer would come out having written for a group of instruments that had not been composed for previous to this, but in this particular case, a masterwork. Of course, the first movement theme comes from a theme that he used, that he wrote 12 years prior to this particular piece, but he never used. The third movement, the Adagio Mesto, it was a rarity. The tempo marking for the third movement was a rarity during the course of Brahms' compositional life. Mesto, meaning sorrowful, was one of the first pieces. There was another horn piece, but this particular piece was written the year after his mother had died, Christiane. He was very close to her, and of course the assumption is that because he played the horn as a child, along with the piano and the cello, that the horn occupied a very important place in his oral memory. So, we hope you enjoy the trio by Johannes Brahms. Thank you very much for coming this evening.
Thank you. Thank you. This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.